Right. So
I like this one. If you had to pick one differential equation as the one that advanced the study of physics the most, which one would you pick? Hamilton's equations for classical mechanics, Maxwell's for electrodynamics, Schrodinger equation for quantum mechanics, Einstein field equations, or something else?
That's like asking me to choose between my children. I mean, they're not my children, but that is like, they're all remarkable structures. Which one has changed the physics the most? Go back, give them to me again.
Hamilton's?
Okay, so Hamilton's equations, or the basic equations of classical mechanics. They tell you how classical mechanical systems, they are the predictive equations for how particles move, for how anything changes with time. Obviously, they have had an enormous impact in physics, and the impact covers every area of physics, every area. They're there in quantum mechanics, they're there in classical mechanics, they're there in quantum field theory, they're everywheres. Okay, what was the next one?
Maxwell's equations. Maxwell's
equations are a little more special. They're a little more special. They have to do with a specific class of phenomena. Electricity and magnetism, electromagnetic fields. So they're a little bit narrower, but on the other hand, they did something remarkable. They taught us what light is. Up until Maxwell's equations, nobody knew what light was. So how do you compare something like Maxwell's equations with that other fellow, Hamilton's equations? Which one is more important? It's a matter of taste. Do you think explaining light was more important or less important than having a framework for, in a sense, all of physics? It's a matter of taste.
I like those t-shirts that have the Maxwell's
equations.
I
have the Maxwell's equations.
Let there be light.
What was the third one?
Next was Schrodinger's equation.
Okay, so Schrodinger's equation, Schrodinger's equation has different meanings to sometimes to physicists. It can mean a very general kind of equation, which tells you how the quantum state of a system changes with time, or it can mean the very specific equation that Schrodinger wrote down. The very specific equation that Schrodinger wrote down had to do with, again, a special class of phenomena, motion of a particle, quantum mechanical motion of a particle. But there's a generalization of it. There's a generalization of it that has to do with how any quantum system behaves. In a sense, it's as broad and as important as Hamilton's equations. It is to quantum mechanics what Hamilton's equations were to classical mechanics. So extremely important. But I think in the end you're going to have a hard time getting me to say I favor one over the other.
What about the field equations?
The Einstein field equations, yes. They, of course, are the sort of quintessential deep, deep equations about what space and time are. They're like Maxwell's equations in that they govern a special class of phenomena, gravity in this case, but they're more than that. They're telling us something extremely deep about the nature of space and time, that it's curved, that the geometry of space and time is not what Euclid thought it was, and how that geometry responds to matter. So again, it's you certainly picked what I would say are the four most important, deepest, favorite equations of theoretical physicists, for sure. I am going to refuse to pick between them. There are four of them, I have four children, and never would I pick between my four children.
When we get a theory that encompasses all of this, is it going to be described with the differential equation?
Oh boy, is the final theory going to be described by a differential equation? Okay, so there are a lot of people, and I'm not going to place myself right now, there are a lot of people who think the world is really discrete. Space and time might be discrete, comes in little elementary steps. If that's the case, then at that level, at the smallest possible distances in the world, it might mean that the mathematics of it is discrete mathematics, the mathematics of little steps, indivisible steps, and not smooth, continuous evolution. If that's the case, no, it won't be described by differential equations. But we don't know. If I knew the answer to that, I would publish it.
Yes, in this class we model phenomena discretely, even when the underlying assumption is that it's continuous.
Exactly.
But the computer programs all have to increment.
Exactly. So you see that in many cases it really is not possible to tell whether a certain equation is describing something which is truly continuous or whether it's describing some discrete phenomena where the little steps occur fast enough and one after another, too fast to be able to see. Okay, so we don't know what the final theory of nature will be.